Amen. This morning we are grateful for the goodness and the mercies of the Lord upon our lives. He has shown us love, and we are here to give Him praise and adoration. Amen. Hallelujah. Eh. Hallelujah. Oh. Hallelujah. Eh. Is a sound of victory. Hallelujah. Eh. Hallelujah. Oh. Let the sound of rejoicing fill this house. Hallelujah. Eh. Hallelujah. Eh.
Bless God for giving us another beautiful Sunday. Hallelujah. On behalf of Jesus Christ, the head of the church, and his manservant, our Papa, Reverend Sidney Alla Mensah, I welcome you all to today's Seekers service. Amen. Shall we take note of the following announcements? We encourage all that if you have any testimony or thanksgiving to share, kindly see any of the altar or the admin team, and they will give you a slot. We discourage the use of mobile phones during church services. This is to allow you focus and avoid distraction. However, if your phone has your Bible on it, we encourage you to put your phone on flight mode again to allow you focus and avoid distraction. Your personal security is very important to us. Your personal belongings, we encourage you all to take very good care of your personal belongings. The restrooms are located to my left, which are to your right, and we have trash bins at vantage points for your use. And there are three ways you can connect with us via our social media handles on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram, all at City of His Presence. And I'll take this opportunity to welcome all of our online community. God richly bless you wherever you have joined us to worship today. We always take pleasure in having you join us. Hallelujah. Amen. Like you've always been doing, help us share the gospel by sharing the link to friends and family. Create watch parties as we go ahead and spread the gospel throughout the world. Hallelujah. Enjoy the service.
Amen. Shall we please be upstanding as we enter time of prayer? Please tell somebody you are welcome. Tell somebody you are looking nice. Tell somebody you are welcome to the Seeker service, where your victory is assured. Amen. The Bible said in Psalm 90 verse 1, the prayer of Moses, he said, "O Lord, thou hast been my dwelling place from generations. Thou hast been my dwelling place from generations." And the verse 2 says that before the mountains were brought forth, before thou had formed the earth, thou art God. We want to thank God. We want to tell him that we are grateful for his goodness. We are grateful for his mercies. We are grateful for his kindness. I want you to lift up a prayer of gratitude. Gratitude. The prayer of Moses said that God has been our dwelling place. God has been our dwelling place. We want to thank God for being our dwelling place, for taking us through the week, for giving us many victories day in, day out. So somebody lift up your voice. For thou hast been my dwelling place. Divinal of the rescue, the creator of the universe, the creator of the earth, the creator of the sun, the creator of the moon. We worship you, we praise thy name, the giver of our life, the giver of our life. Rapayata, ayata, yapayata, 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 yapayata. We are free.
Lord, to you. We are grateful unto you this morning.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible said in John chapter 17, verse 2, he said, and Jesus prayed, he said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son so that I glorify you. We are lifting up a prayer to the heavens. We are praying that every session of the service will bring glory to God, that the worship will bring glory to God, that the praise will bring glory to God, that the word ministration will bring glory to God, that every aspect, even our community meetings, will bring glory to God. Everything we do in this service will bring glory to God. Somebody lift up your voice. Acts chapter 2 verse 2, the day of Pentecost, it says that when the Holy Spirit came, there was a mighty rushing wind. There was a mighty rushing wind. We are praying. The Holy Spirit is also known as the Spirit of Life. He's the one that brings life into services. We want the vibrance of the Holy Spirit. We don't want any dormant service, any dull service. We want to pray for an energy of the Holy Spirit. Just as that day, a mighty rushing wind, we want to pray that the same vibrance will be in the service, the same energy, the same atmosphere will be in this service, that the Holy Ghost will take charge just as on that day in the name of Jesus, and that this service will have life. The service will have life. Somebody lift up your voice and pray.
Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, saturate the atmosphere. I'm gonna go to the hospital.
Amen. We are lifting up another prayer. We are lifting up another prayer. Sometimes a man can change your life. Sometimes a service can change your life. Elijah met the widow of Zarephath and he changed her life. This service can change your life. We are interceding for anybody who is losing hope in life, that because of this service, because of the word of God that will come, because of fervent singing, and because of this service, just as Elijah encountered that woman and her life changed. The Bible said she was there with the last food, so she would die, but she met a man. Today, I'm telling you, beat a service. We are lifting up a prayer. We are interceding. Anyone who is losing hope, we are praying. As a result of this service, the hope will be restored.
Amen.
As a result of Reverend Sydney and the word he will bring, hope will be restored in somebody's life. Somebody open your mouth. Awesome service you are about to give us. Father, we pray that you take charge of this service. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. I still want you to be in the mood of worship. Kindly be in the mood of worship as we worship our Maker this morning. God has indeed been good unto us. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel say. That is what David said. If it had not been the Lord who was on your side, you wouldn't be here by now. But we thank God that the snare is broken and our souls have escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. I just want you to be in the mood of worship. You need to give your God a praise. Say thank you unto your Maker. Someone speak in the spirit, speak in the language that the Lord hears. Shataya kalalala. Speak in the language that your Father understands. Thank you, Father, for your mercies. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the forgiveness of sins. Thank you for the breath that we continue to breathe in. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for everything that you continue to do in our lives. We bless you, Jesus. We bless Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus.
Most High God of heavens, Most High Ruler of the earth, come on and sing with me.
Most High
God.
are the kings of kings and the lords of lords. None shall be compared unto you, Father. If it had not been you, we wouldn't be here today. We bless your holy name, Father. Thank you, Jesus, for accepting our worship. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you all for joining us worship this morning. I want you to turn left and right to your neighbor and give your neighbor a beautiful smile. Give your neighbor a beautiful smile. Amen. Amen. And I want us to be in the reggae mood this morning. I want to put you in the reggae mood as we continue to worship our Maker. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know about you, but I have made up my mind to go God's way, to follow the Lord, regardless of the circumstance where I find myself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back.
Rock. The rock is
This morning, I don't know why you are here, but most often than not, we go to the house of the Lord for our needs to be met. Amen. For the things that we were unable to do it on our own, for the Lord to do it. So the other time, the woman with the issue of blood, the Bible says that for so many years, he was uncomfortable in his situation, but he tried to see Jesus. And lo and behold, the Bible says that when he saw Jesus, his issue was resolved. So once you have come into the presence of the Lord this morning, I want to assure you on behalf of our Papa that as the word comes, as you dance, as you inculcate yourself into whatever we are going to do, the Lord will also visit you. Amen.
Amen.
And most often, you know, the great men of God will tell you that the greatest decision that they took in their life, they took it whilst they were in the presence of the Lord, whether they were in their chambers or in the church. God really bless you. It's my time, 8 minutes. Okay, so we want to pray. This week, may your glory fall upon me.
Amen.
Even as I come into your presence, as I leave here and go home, as I leave here and go to the office, as I leave here and go into my place of business, let your blessings be upon my life. Let your hands be upon me. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Rapa skedededes le taya tada. Rapa antada bes le paya tedede. Rapa antada das le paya tedede. Rantede bes le paya tedede. Rapa antada da 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 da. Lord, your blessings, O Lord, let your blessings be upon us as we go to work this week, O Lord, as we move about in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.
Amen.
Your expectation, one of your expectations this morning, is to be in consonance with the Jabez man in 1 Chronicles chapter 4 and verse number 10. The Bible says that Jabez was an honorable man and he had, you know, dignity upon his head. But there was something that he wanted the Lord to do for him. So he prayed a certain prayer and then he said that, oh, what thou wouldst bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thine hand might be with me, and that thou wouldn't keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And the Bible says that, and God granted him that which he requested. Yeah, we want to pray that, Lord, enlarge our territories this week. Lord, expand us wherever we go. Let your favor be upon us. Lord, open our eyes to certain glorious things in life that we may be able to grab it. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Lord, like Jabez prayed, like Jabez prayer, we pray that, Lord, expand our territory this week. As we come in, Lord, as we go to the office, as we go to our business places, as we go to our jobs, Lord, as we go looking for money, Lord, and this world. And there are people who are wicked, unreasonable men and women who are wicked, who wanted to remove you from your position in the office, who wanted to clear you off. Nkawuko jomwa, nkaya ntowa dia. Ye pompaya no penia kachira di serade. Keep us from the men of unreasonable, wicked men and women. Open your mouth and begin to pray. As we go out there, as we go to work, oh Lord, as we move about, oh Lord, we declare that, Lord, deliver us from all evil. Deliver us from evil people. Deliver us from evil people. From reasonable men and women. Deliver us from evil. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rapa and Tanada. Church, the Bible says in the Ephesians chapter 2 and verse number 11 that he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. You catch what I say, my pastors and teachers, omumbra asafunumu. My prophets, embra asafunumu, my enkrofwa omoye apostle, raise men and women who will carry on your church. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Lord, we pray that raise prophets into the church, oh Lord. Lord, raise apostles in the church. Lord, raise teachers in the church. Lord, raise pastors in the church. Lord, raise
Amen.
You are lifting up your final prayer, and that is the prayer that, Lord, let me benefit from the service this morning. As your manservant is about to minister, Lord, I pray that transform my life. Let the word that is about to come transform my life. Let my life never be the same as I come here. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Lord, we pray that, Lord, our expectation this morning is that you change our lives. Our expectation this morning is that you transform our life. Our expectation this morning is that when your word falls, oh Lord, it will change us. It will give us business ideas. Your word this morning will heal our diseases. Your word this morning, oh Lord, will impact on our lives. And we will never be the same as we came, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, we bless your name this morning for the opportunity given unto us, O Lord. Father, we pray like Jabez prayed. Expand our territories, O Lord, and deliver us from evil as we go out there this week, O Lord, as we go for lectures, as we go on our business trip, as we go to office, O Lord, continue to protect us, and then raise men and women, O Lord, to build up your church. In Jesus' mighty name, and let the church say, Amen.
Hallelujah. Kindly take your seats. Amen. Amen.
Corinthians chapter 9 verse 15. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 15. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Our Papa is thanking God today for adding another beautiful year to his age. Amen. And I read, our Papa is thanking God for another year. He prays God keeps ordering his steps to his will for his life. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Psalm 107, verse 1. Psalm 107, verse 1, I read. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. I take it again. Psalm 107, verse 1. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Hallelujah. Amen. God's steadfast love towards us endures forever. One of our ways of honoring the Lord is through our offering. It's time for us to take our first offering. We are honoring our Lord for loving us regardless, for taking very good care of us regardless. I want you to dip your hands into your coffers. Take an appreciable amount of money, something you know it is worthy to be given unto your Maker as an offering unto him. If your offering is ready, kindly lift it up high above your head, and in just a minute, say thank you unto the Lord, for his mercies endure forever. In Jesus' name we prayed. Amen. You could also give via Momo or through our account details on the screen. Our online audience, kindly do the needful.
Today, our song is simply recognizing that the God we serve, he truly lives up to all the attributes that we give to him. We say he's the counselor, he is the counselor. When we say he's our comforter, we say he truly is our comforter. And whenever we are in pain or we are in trouble, we find ourselves hopelessly falling before his throne. Join us as we worship this morning. Amen.
Thank you.
Father, as I lift my right hand, I pray the Lord speak to me, speak to me in the name of Jesus. Lord, speak to me in the name of Jesus. Lord, speak to me. Lord, speak to me in the name of Jesus. Lord, speak to me in the name of Jesus. Lord, speak to us in the name of Jesus.
Together once again.
Amen.
May this heart hear your word.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Please clap your hands and have your seat. Hallelujah. Look at somebody, say, a church is a place you have to be. Say, a church is a place you have to be. Say, I am your family. Hallelujah. Amen. I believe it's a good place to clap your hands for Jesus. The reason why the early church increased and increased and increased and increased, because they realized that they were family. They saw each other. They loved each other. They spoke to each other. They blessed each other. They ate together. They did most things together. And the power of God was with them as well. Amen. And I believe that God will give that grace to the church in our generation and in this dispensation. Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to quickly join me and open your Bibles to the book of Joshua chapter 4 verse 21 to 22. I want to end my series on the foundation stone, and I've been dealing with evangelism last week, and I want to finish it this Sunday. Hallelujah. Joshua chapter 4 verse 21 to 22. Joshua chapter 4 verse 21 to 20. I want to encourage you to, you know, always come to church with a notebook and write it. Write what the pastor is saying so you can go and refer, and also, you know, study about it, and you can use it for your quiet time. It will help you spiritually as well. And I read, when the children shall ask their fathers in time to come, saying, what mean these stones? Then ye shall let your children know. Joshua chapter 4, verse 21 to 22. And I want you to travel with me to Ephesians chapter 2, verse 20. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 20. It says that, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophet, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20. And are built upon the foundation of the apostle and prophet, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Hallelujah. Somebody say stone. Say stones. Say foundation. Amen. The few past weeks we've been talking about the foundation of the apostolic church, and that is the foundational stones. Amen. And I said last week that the dictionary says that foundation is the very basis upon which something stands. Say stand. Say stand. So foundations are incredibly important, and that is why every structure needs a foundation. Foundation does not change or move because the building is renovated. Foundation remains the same even if the building is renovated. Hallelujah. If you want to change the foundation, it means that you need to pull down the structure and then dig out all the foundations and then do another foundation again. So that means that foundation is very, very important. Amen. And most of the times as believers, we do not understand some of these things. Even in relationship, the very things that you start in the relationship that makes the relationship work, when you finally settle, do not stop that thing. Hallelujah. Because there is some foundation that you laid that has helped you and helped you for you to get to where you are. And most of us here, whilst growing up from Sunday school, there are so many things that we were taught that when we grew up and became matured Christians, it has either left us or we do not remember one way or the other. But the truth of the matter is that these foundations, they are things that build the church. And when they are not there, the church will collapse. Am I communicating? I spoke to you about number one foundation, which is oneness. Hallelujah. I spoke to you about number two foundation, which is salvation. I spoke to you about number three foundation, which is stewardship. I spoke to you number four about worship. Hallelujah. And I'm speaking to you today about evangelism. These are foundations that the church stands upon. Say foundation. Tap somebody's hand gently and say, you need this foundation. Say, you need this foundation. Say, you need oneness. Oh, I didn't say look somewhere. Oh, I said look into the face. Hallelujah. Say, you need oneness. You need salvation. You need stewardship. You need worship. You need evangelism. I want to encourage you to go back to YouTube. You can watch some of these series that I've preached, and it will help you if you want to critically follow. Amen. Hallelujah. Give me the NCV version of Acts chapter 20, verse 24. Acts chapter 20, verse 24. The most important thing is that I complete my mission. The work that the Lord Jesus gave me to tell the people the good news about God's grace. Hallelujah. That's the most important. The most important thing in your life is to tell people about the work of God. That is the most important thing. It's not about your career and all those things. Your primary purpose on earth is for you to propagate the gospel, for you to tell somebody about Jesus Christ. Am I communicating here? And last week I spoke to you about why Jesus's mission should matter to you. And number one, I said that if you want to be like Jesus, then your life mission should be like Jesus's life mission. Am I communicating here? I told you that Jesus's mission to preach the gospel and continue preaching the gospel, and for some reason he had to die for you and I, it is our responsibility to continue that mission. Somebody say mission. Say mission. It is our responsibility to continue mission. We don't wait till when we are about to die before we say we want to continue that mission. I went for a funeral at Bogoso this weekend, and then it was a Catholic church, and when the priest was speaking, he said that our uncle comes to church like twice in a year. I don't know what will be said about you when you die. Hallelujah. Will your man of God say, you come, every man you appear one, every man you appear one. Hallelujah. And he was not shy to say that. And it's an example, whilst the coffin or the casket was there, and he said it. He's trying to tell us something here. That one day life will cease to exist. That one day we will all be in this casket one way or the other. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. That should our life be in that way where we appear in church, you know, on occasion. Some they appear in church on Easter, Christmas. Hallelujah. When there is a program and they invite a prophet with a cassock, then they will appear. Hallelujah. That when he enters the building, his perfume alone, and somebody says, I know this man is really anointed. He's not held the microphone, but I can tell he's anointed. People are judging anointing by perfume. Am I communicating? Now, I remember when we were growing up, sometimes we see some of these men, their shoes alone, we are like, today, I know I'll get blessed. Because when we look at how their shoes are shining, we know this man came to actually bless us. And whilst I was in the church, I looked at the casket there, and I was like, God, I could have done something about this. I could have traveled all these, traveling at the time he died, to, you know, go and speak the word of God to him one way or the other. Even the twice he appeared in church, and you know, some people, they pay their tithe because they know when something happens, somebody has to do something to them. I'm not digressing for my preaching. Hallelujah. Amen. But I know there are people like that. Sometimes they wait when they are about to get married. They see they are bringing the tithe, and pastor is, why is this thing happening at this time? And it's obvious because he knows that they will go into the record and see what is your contribution to the church. Am I communicating? And this man will give his contributions and all that, you know, to the wife, and the wife will go and pay. Because he knows that one day when he's not there, it's the church that has to give him a befitting burial. Should our lifestyle be like that? When we wait for something to happen before, it should not be so. Am I communicating here? And that is why you need to take your life, your church life, seriously. Am I communicating? There are people that say it's the whole Sunday morning that their dress will be washed well. It's only Sunday that the dress will be washed well. Hallelujah. That say, for me, my washing is only on Sunday morning. In 3 hours that you have to give to God, it says, I have to wash. Am I communicating here? And sometimes you look at the track record of these certain individuals and Kai. It's serious, man. We're in the car coming and, you know, driving very fast. I wanted to make sure I don't miss my flight. And we had a wonderful conversation with, you know, one of the brothers of the family, And sometimes you wonder what you wonder some things that people go through. And it's indeed that if we take Christ's mission as our mission, or really, you see, it will not only help us, but it will change our life as well. Am I communicating? That a woman can give birth to about 9 children, all of them different fathers. 9 different fathers. And while she's still giving birth, the daughters are also giving birth, also different fathers. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. And when we are dealing with, you see, this church thing is spiritual, it's not physical. That's why the Bible says we do not fight against flesh and blood, but against principality. The enemy knows whilst you enter here, it's battle. So he will do everything to make sure you do not enter. Am I communicating? I dare bet tearfully when you know now it's too late. Am I communicating here? So Jesus expects me to continue what his life mission. And that is why it should matter to me. Look at somebody say, you have to continue. Amen. I don't know how you would let sharing of the gospel be a privilege to you, but it has to be a privilege to you. And you can do it in so many ways and so many forms. One of the ways you can do it is that as I'm speaking right now, you can go to our YouTube channel and then share the message so that somebody will be blessed. You can go to our Facebook and comment, and somebody will be blessed, because the algorithm will let a lot of people see it and also listen to it. Am I communicating here? So sharing the gospel should be a privilege to you. Somebody say a privilege. Say a privilege. Hallelujah. And I also said that apart from it being a privilege to you, people are lost without Jesus and they need to hear about him. All that they need to do is to what? Is to believe. Say believe. Say believe. You see, during the times of the disciples, can you imagine Peter walked around touching people, receiving miracles? He wakes up in the morning, Obayare, bring the child, touch, healed. This one say, I can't see, bring, touch, healed. They experienced wonderful miracles and they were so comfortable. They were comfortable at where they were, but 99.9% percent of some people in the world did not experience that miracle and that word. They did not hear about Jesus. And God realized that, no, I have to do something about this. Am I communicating? And one of the things that I can do is to make sure that I unsettle their comfortability. And that is why God can unsettle your what? Your comfortability. Am I communicating? I told you that there are some things that happen in your life. They are not always the devil. Sometimes God can bring certain things in your path because of what is ahead of you. Am I communicating? You might be binding Lucifer, but it's not Lucifer. Hallelujah. Amen. Job would not have received double if God had not permitted the devil in his space. Am I communicating? And he even received as much as he had even before the enemy encroached in his space. God realized that I need to unsettle these people, because the longer they are in Jerusalem, people will not hear about me, Jesus. And Jesus realized that, no, something would have to be done. Am I communicating? The real danger of church or ministry or our lives is that when we are always comfortable at where we are, comfortable air condition, comfortable seat. Amen. The next time you come, maybe we have changed all these chairs. It's the chairs that you sit that it will be massaging your back. You don't believe it. Hallelujah. Amen. But the question is that, will it be a test of your comfortability? That when pastor say, let's go out, and you say, this comfortable chair, I should go up. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. But there are times in our life where God says, you know what? You have forgotten about your mission in this world. Your mission is to speak about me to others. I spoke to you last week. How many of you have stars in heaven? Stars in heaven. Stars. Not quarter star. Stars in heaven. Hallelujah. How many of you can sincerely put your hand on your chest and say, I have won a soul to Jesus Christ? How many of you can say that? It's entirely embarrassing that as a believer, after about 15 or 20 years of your life, you cannot count it that I have indeed won somebody for Christ. You see, church has become the type of church where people enter the church because they are looking for something. And what they are looking for is either their money doubles or they get a promotion in life. But there is this word that we cannot shy away from. Seek ye first. And it's a principle that Jesus works with. He says, if you seek me first, then every other thing will be added unto you. Am I communicating? Every other thing will be given to you. It's all about him what first. And he's saying that what? Do my will. Do my will. Do my will. Speak about me. Tell people about me. In your small space, in your small corner, in your family, in your life, speak about me. Look at somebody and say, speak about Jesus. Say, speak about Jesus. Hallelujah. And I said the last time that church has become come to me mentality. The Spirit will do the work mentality. Hallelujah. And we have so many people, when maybe your pastor, I like to use Pastor Jesse a lot because he's very much vocal. And when you Pastor Jesse say, please come, let's go and do follow-up. Like last week and this week it was follow-up. And come, let's do follow-up. And some say, the Spirit will do the work. Have you not heard it before? That God can release his angels on assignment. And yes, God can do that. Hallelujah. But when we have all agreed to embark on something, we all come together and then do it. Am I communicating? Tap somebody high five real hard, and tell the person you have to be there. Say the Spirit can do it, but the Spirit needs you. Am I communicating? You see, the truth of the matter is that whilst I am speaking, the Spirit is convicting your heart. And that is why somebody will close and not speak to me personally, but will say that, why is it that Pastor Sydney is preaching against me? But I'm not preaching against you. I am preaching the word of God. But it is the Spirit of God that is convicting your heart. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. So people are fun of the Spirit will do the work mentality. And then the perfect church first. It has to be about the perfect church. We need to build ourselves spiritual. We need to be strong. Because the wizard, they have double portion anointing. So we have to build ourselves. Because whilst I'm going, I don't know, somebody can throw his hand, car, and some power will enter me. Can you imagine a believer speaking like that? And because of that, you know what? Let's prepare ourselves some 40 days fasting, or maybe 50 days, which I don't think we will do some again because I was left alone in the 50 days. Anyway, I was the one who heard the voice. Someone say, yeah. And after the 40 days fasting, and then we will go and then speak the word of God. But ask the person, if we declare even 7 days fasting, how many of us will sincerely do it just because of evangelism? 7 days for evangelism. Some of you will break at 9 a.m., 6 to 9. But if we say, let the heavens open, prophetic program, that money has to be released. Everybody will. Hallelujah. Amen. But when we say evangelism, let's fast. No, don't fast. You see, the least things that you shy away from, they are the ones that God even indeed blesses. Because that is the work that touches his heart. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. Amen. Whilst Jerusalem was a comfortable place for them, where the rich were there, where they are stood, we call the executive church. Somebody say the executive church. Have you heard some before? There are some certain service they call the executive service. Hallelujah. Where the rich people, you know, the well-to-do in society are the ones that come. Executive church. When you say lift up your hands and everybody is like this. Hallelujah. Because they are so much blessed that they don't see the reason to lift up their hands to the Lord. That now they are bargaining with God and telling God that you are the one that blessed me. So I choose to lift my hand or not to lift my hand. The Jerusalem church was full of some of these blessings that they felt like, listen, going out to do the work of God, no. We need to be comfortable here. But you see, there are times where God will discomfort you. And one thing that God did was when Stephen died. Somebody say Stephen. Say Stephen. Say Stephen. The honeymoon was shattered by the martyrdom of Stephen. All of a sudden, the Jerusalem honeymoon had to be shattered. And it was because Stephen died. And it was a medium at which God wanted to unsettle their comfortability. Now, immediately Stephen died, like, no, we have to wake up. Something is happening. You see, when family members are dying, now you are thinking, is it my turn? Hallelujah. Especially when within a year, 1 month, this one go, 1 month, and you track it, and they are all in the same age, and you find that you are in the same age. Now you are coming. Reverend, Madonikaba. Reverend, you have to declare fasting for me. Because the way people are dying, now you begin to dream self-dream, dreams that God has not given to you. You begin to dream. And you count. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. So all of a sudden, when Stephen died, they were like, no. Listen, we have to do something about this. Because we don't know. Somebody is killing somebody. And the person is by the name Saul. And if we don't start hiding, Peter, it will be my turn. James, it will be my turn. So the Bible says in Acts chapter 8 verse 1, it says that, and Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time, there was a great persecution. Let's read together. Is there? Let's read it, church. Except what? The apostle. Somebody say Saul. Say Saul. Saul started killing them. Say killing them. And in killing them, they realized that no, we have to do something about it. Look at somebody say, Ubema ukwanse nyamepe unsettle wana bisano. Now, can you imagine if that your money in your bank account, God unsettles your money because of his purpose? You know, we will never discern that. We will always think it is some warlord in the family that is touching our finances. Hallelujah. Am I communicating here? Sometimes God works in what? In mysterious ways. The swift persecution made them come to a place to understand that, listen, we have to obey the voice of God. And sometimes God can unsettle you because he wants you to obey what? His voice. Somebody say obedience. Say obedience. This promising CEO by the name Stephen now finally had to die. He was promising because look at how he spoke. He spoke. He lamented. The guy lamented. Everybody was shocked, and now they said, no, this one is blasphemy. We have to kill him. He was a promising CEO. The man who could have led a battalion of believers to propagate the gospel. They annihilated him. He had to die. But God had a reason. God had a reason. Because God realized that, I cannot let these people stay there in Jerusalem. Be there all the time and be comfortable with the power they wield. Be healed. See, come to me. And they are all fine. They are all comfortable. No, he said, no. If I have to let somebody's life go for them to move so that today you and I will be here, I will do it. Because of Stephen, the word moved from Jerusalem to so many areas because of what Stephen. Am I communicating here? Listen, look at somebody say God can be radical. I I know one day this message somebody will take and say, man of God said God can be radical. Yeah. Hallelujah. God can be. There are times God can shake you. And I don't know how many of us would pray that prayer. God, shake my life. Hallelujah. Tap somebody on the shoulder. Say, Lord, shake my life. You couldn't say that. I believe it's a good place to clap your hands. God believes in hell. God, he believes in hell. And that is why he sent his son to come and die for you and I. Because he believes what? In hell. But you see, I came to tell you this morning that if you will not go, there are two things that will happen. If God is sending you and you will not go, there are two things that will happen. Persecution. Number one, persecution. And how will he persecute you? He will drive you out. Amen. He will let certain things happen to you that he will what? He will drive you out. Number two, substitution. If you will not go, he will replace you. Either he drives you out or he will what? He will replace you. Replacing you means that he will find someone else who will go willingly, not unwillingly, willingly, because God will not force you out of your will. Am I communicating? Willingly, he will look for somebody. And that is why God is raising an army. But I don't know whether you'll be part of it willingly. But as willingly as you'll be part, he will give you the unction. He will give you the power and raise the next Billy Graham in our generation. In the name of Jesus Christ. And raise the next Billy Graham in our generation and the next. In the name of Jesus Christ. And next, raise the next bishops in our generation in the name of Jesus Christ. I've known women that God has raised them. They are very sharp. Emma, if women avail themselves and they are used by God, oh my God, it's so deep. Because I found myself, I was under a prophetess who was a woman, very anointed and very powerful. Am I communicating? I want you to look at somebody gently. Say, Awo. Catch and let Awo. Say, Ankwa. Nyame. Obo yo bi muako. Non suni judgment. Oh. Hallelujah. Now, how will God judge you on this? Limited stars. Not even limited stars. Zero. Am I communicating? And it's true that when we get to heaven, people say, when I get to heaven, I'll ask God so many questions. You cannot ask him so many questions. Because you'll be in the glory of the Son. And in the glory of the Son, you get to know everything. You get to know why this thing happened. So there will not be a coffee meeting between you and God and ask God questions. It won't happen. Because immediately you enter into his bosom, you'll be in the fullness of his glory. You will know what happened in the past and what is even about to happen. Am I communicating here? Listen, because of Stephen martyrdom, it changed a man for life. That we mention the name every time. We even have one called here, Paul. Hallelujah. May he be that Paul. I wish I was called Paul. That I pray that grace on Paul will be upon my life. Hallelujah. I'm not saying name your son Paul. Am I communicating here? Because of this, God lifted a man by the name Saul to become what? Paul. Now imagine. And that was what? Substitution. Am I communicating? You see, let me just digress a bit. There are people when they are doing the work of God in the house of the house, hey, you know, I'm not there. I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. I'm not out. You know, that sort of thing. He says that if no one worships me, I will do what? I will raise what? I will raise stones. Hallelujah. I will raise stones. There was some years ago, personal testimony. When we were at a yard for, we were praying, God. There were times we could do service.
and then our pastor will not be around. And you know, Pastor Paul, he can't play the keys well as we want. Although he's trying to learn, but still not done with his course. And we're praying. Say, God, do something. Because there were times where choir will be there. No keyboardist. God, what's happening? We look at our left. Nobody to play drums. Say, hey, Brady. And sometimes we're like, God, did you call me? And we started praying. Say, God, this is your church, oh, it's not mine. If I'm not there, you raise somebody to continue. Somebody in this congregation to continue. I mean, Pengu, but imagine that once on my way from Bogos when something happened. Something happened. Why this road, jaka road like that? Because of this government we have. Hallelujah. After about a month, and I'm gone, they will look and say, their council will meet and say, ah, now let's see who can now take over. Now they begin to do their calculation. And after doing calculation, they spiritually zoom and pray. And God say, ah, let's let this person continue. Listen, God will always raise men and women for his work. Am I communicating? And for glorious reason. Hey, this man appeared, oh. This man appeared. Ah! Look at the way you are clapping. You don't know what it means, oh. You don't know what it means. Listen, I spoke to a man of God. He said, Charlie, I'm looking for guys who can just come and play and even go. Guys who are not even in the spirit. You have this man, he's in the spirit. He can connect with me. Guys who go and play shabu. Hallelujah. The ones they raise their legs like that. And they'll come and no spirit filled thing. And they go. And God being so good, he could have gone to the US or Bahamas or somewhere. Hallelujah. Now he could have been in Colorado. You will go, don't worry. Amen. But you are in this season for a purpose. Am I communicating here? And we're looking and saying, God, this thing. We had a guy who was playing the drum. Tale, when we have occasion like Easter, we call this guy, his phone is off. Call him, Tale. Call him, his phone is off. After 2 days, now he's saying,
Reverend, my name is Uncle Yario.
In that Sunday where we are all expecting, choir is ready to come and sing. I turn, I look at no drama. I say, God, what's happening? And then God being so good, this man appeared. If I tell you how God did it for him, listen, you need to value relationship. Some of you look at people anyhow, you treat them anyhow. Today you are somebody say, I'll say, I'll cry your chaplain can be nimu baby. But say nimu chaplain tenimu. Hallelujah. Chaplain tenimu. Let's value relationship. Am I communicating? Hallelujah. And yummy size. We are in the same grace. I'm not bigger than you. You are not bigger than me. We are all under this. It's a privilege I am here. It's just a privilege that I'm here. I'm speaking to you. Am I communicating here? Value relationship. And by God's grace, we had consistency. Am I communicating? How even God brought a queer into the church, I'm telling you, is grace. Am I communicating? You see, when we have a privilege to serve, we should serve in truth. And in reverence to God, not any man. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. And indeed, God raised somebody like Paul to continue the assignment. And look at what Paul did. People see him, and even he himself said, he said, I am not boasting, but I am above all my brethren. That is audacity to speak. I speak in tongues more than all of you. Even the tongues of angels. Charlie. loaded, loaded. Am I communicating? A guy who was persecuting, he was chasing Nana to kill him. And now he can go around and preach the gospel. And this is what God can do. May God use somebody like that. In the name of Jesus Christ. May God use somebody like that. In the name of Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 11 verse 19 to 21. Let's read it so I prove it to you that this is how God works. Let's read. It says that what? Now they were, And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number believed and turned. You see what God can do? Somebody say Antioch. Now, who knew that the word of God could go to Antioch? But it could have stayed in Jerusalem. But it went to what? Antioch. And Antioch was most gentle city. And it is inconceivable that they should ignore but a small minority of Jews, assuming that they are the only ones that God wanted to save. No, no, no. They were the first group that did it. And can you imagine that the word Christian or followers of Christ came from Antioch? Am I communicating? And they were the first church that sent Paul out. And they said, my guy, you have to go to Tarsus. Go to your hometown and go and preach. Where you were a bad boy there. Go and start there. Hallelujah. How many of you would like to go to where you had the worst and messed life? They said, go there. And if you look at it, I'm sure Paul would say, but when I go, will they receive me? Am I communicating? Some of us, when we became born again Christian, and some of our friends would say, I will ensure that's the son. But see, you know, hallelujah. Someone say, you see, Jerusalem never knew that God was raising a revivalist by the name Apostle Paul. Somebody say Apostle Paul. But it was because God had to break their comfortability for Stephen to be martyred, and then out of that the gospel spread and even Paul was saved. Listen, when it comes to the gospel, it's about sacrifice. Somebody say sacrifice. Have you read somewhere in the Bible where it say, if you have to follow me, you have to what? Deny what? Yourself. It says your family will not even what? Like you. Am I communicating? Hallelujah. Your family will not like you. Am I communicating? Like Alfred is going to speak the word of God, and the wife will say, no, today stay with me. I want to be comfortable. Why today of today you want to go and speak about the word of God? I want you by my side. Hey. Hallelujah. And when he says, no, I have to go, they say, but do you love me? Hey. You don't know, but do you love me? And you have to choose between God and your wife. Because when you come back home, it's either there will be too much salt in the food, or you sit down alone and eat. Am I communicating here? There are times where you will have friction with your family because of Christ Jesus. Am I committing? And then there were transferring, sir, our church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But you see, if you don't come out and you don't stand with Jesus, you don't expect him to stand with you when you are in trouble. He's a loving father.
Somebody say God is not partial. Okay. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah.
Jerusalem was unwilling to change, but God decided to change them. And the only way is not to stop their gift. The only way is for somebody to die. It's not to stop. God gives you gift, he doesn't take it back. So he'll not say, I will stop the healing. No, he won't do that. Am I communicating here? But what he had to do was to unsettle their comfortability. And the only way he could have done that was to make sure that somebody died and somebody pursued them and decided to kill them, because everybody is afraid to die, even when they are following Jesus. If somebody entered this house right now and say, you either say, am I communicating here? Because you want to save your life. Give me Acts chapter 11, verse 25 to 26. Let's read this whilst we pray. Let's read together. Then departed Barnabas to Tarsus. First in what? In Antioch. So the West people used to call you Christian. Where it was first spoken was in Antioch. It was not in Jerusalem. It was in Antioch. Am I communicating here? It was what? In Antioch. Let me tell you a story. There was a place where usually, a channel where usually when ships pass through, they shipwreck. And some people decided that they wanted to help them, those that will be victims of the shipwreck. And they decided to do that for some time. They were helping them. When ships pass there and the ship is shipwrecked, the people would go and save those that might be, drowning and all that. And they would save them. And they would bring them to shore. And they had a small sort of shelter. And they would shelter them there, keep them, make sure they are fit, they are fine. And if they have to find a way to let them go back, they do that. And with time, some of them said, you know what? We want to be part of the life savers. Somebody say life savers. They said, we want to be part of the life savers. So some of the people decided that we will not go back, but we want to be part of the life savers. And they did that for some time. Most of the time, these ships will come, they will shipwreck, and then they will save some. And some of them will say, we want to be part. Some will go, and they started growing. Then whilst their number started becoming big, some of them came out and said, you know what? Why don't we make this place very comfortable? Let's change the beds. Let's get something good that when they come, they will sit on it. They will be comfortable. They will lie on it. Let's get some TV. Let's get some sofa. Let's make the place very beautiful, very nice, so that when these people come, they will be comfortable. And then there was division amongst them. Some said, no, that is not our basis of this place. Our basis is that when the people come, we will look after them, we will shelter them a bit, and then we'll let them go. Those that choose willingly that they want to stay, we'll let them stay. And there was a confusion, argument. This one said that, this one said that. And now they had to vote. Somebody say vote. Now when they voted, majority carried the vote. And they said that, you know what, let's. So they started changing the place. They bought some nice bed, some couch, and all that. And all of a sudden they said, now it's going to be called Life Savers Club. Somebody say Life Savers Club. So now it became a Life Savers Club. And so beautiful as it was. But then those that decided that, listen, we want to be as we were, standing based on our purpose, they realized that those people that said we want to make that, they were deviating from the very course or the very foundation of what they started with. And gradually, as it became big, Some of them who were very comfortable said that, you know what, we want to expand more. So they expanded to some other part of the shore. And those that said that, you know what, we still want to sit or stand on the very foundation of what we started, we want to leave. So they said, we are leaving. We don't want to be part of you. So they left that place, went to another side of the shore and started the Life Savers. And once they started getting some shipwrecked individuals were coming in, and they also started becoming big. And once they were becoming big, then some people rose up and said, no, why don't we make this place comfortable? Get some TVs, get some couch, and get all those things and make the place comfortable. And then there was division and argument, and the majority carried the vote. And then it continued after generations, after generation, after generation, after generation. Now, what is the meaning of this story? The meaning of this story is that when we stick to the purpose that Jesus Christ has given us, it will help us to save the lives we want to save. But as soon as we get comfortable and let other things encroach into our life and into our believer system, then we deviate from the very cause and purpose that Jesus has given us. Please be upstanding on your feet. Look at somebody and tell the person, some wish to leave.
Some wish to leave.
Say
some
wish to leave.
Wish to leave.
Within the sound.
Within the sound.
Of church.
Of church.
Or chapel bell.
Of chapel bell.
I want to run.
I want to run.
A rescue shop.
A rescue shop.
Within a yard of hell.
Within a yard of hell.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that is to say that we need to touch where men have not touched before. Imagine that I come here one Sunday and I say, God willing, by the end of April, we are moving the church to Pampram. We have built an ultra modern church or edifice there, still by the name City of His Presence. And we want to move the church. How many of you follow? Please be sincere. Follow. How many of you? Can I count one? Yeah. It's serious business here. One, two, three. So I get about, yeah. Okay, good. So that's about 20 people here. Hallelujah. The others is like, they are not sure right now. They have to either consult family, consult wife, consult uncle, consult mother. Hallelujah. Am I communicating here? But then let me ask you again. If I come here by the end of this month and I say, we are raising missionaries to go to New York in the U.S., to go and preach the gospel, please, how many of you will go? Please, let's be sincere. No, here we are real people. We are not fake people at all. Please wave your hand. Oh, come on. I am real. Yes, I love my brother. He is real. Hallelujah. Amen. You want to clap your hands for Jesus? Amen. So I want you to do this thing for me. I want you to touch as many, many lovely people in the house as you can. And tell the person, this God, He has ways.
He has ways
to unsettle you.
To unsettle you.
Come on, move around.
This God ways. Has ways to unsettle you. Has ways to unsettle you. Has ways to unsettle you.
Come on, touch somebody. Tell the person, this God.
This God.
He has ways.
He has ways.
To unsettle you.
To unsettle you.
Oh, Jesus. Now, you want to lift up your two hands. Thank you, Jesus. You want to pray and say, Lord.
Lord.
In this month.
in this month
of outreach.
Of outreach.
I want you to help me.
I want you to help me.
Speak the word of God.
Speak the word of God.
Help me.
Help me.
Invite somebody to church. Lord, I have not done that.
Lord, I have not done that.
For a while now.
But this season,
I want to be the one.
I want to be the one.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The next 1 minute, begin to pray. Just be a believer with no stars. You can't win a soul. Somebody might be in your home, your uncle, your auntie, your friend, your brother. And I want you to pray for me. It doesn't mean just open your mouth. Just can come from your heart, and I want you to pray. He can hear you still whilst you pray from your heart and say, Lord, help me. I have an assignment to fulfill, and I want you to help me. 1 minute, just pray. Just pray. No microphones, please. Just pray. Just pray.
Come on, pray. Come on, pray. Sorry, Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen. You want to take your offering? Please, you want to clap your hands for Jesus? And you want to take your offering and your tithe as well whilst we pray. You done that? If you are giving by electronically, you have our account details on the screen. If you are paying through the bank system, you have the bank account number on the screen. Is God is our Light Church International. It's a First Atlantic bank account. If you are paying through Momo, it's an Airtel Tigo number 0267476230. If you are paying through your phone, you can lift up your phone up. If you are paying by hard money or hard currency, you can also lift it up and let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We bless you. We honor your name. We ask that you bless our offerings, bless our seed. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Please, let's take our offering.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life.
To pay particular close attention to this announcement. Before I do that, if this is your first time, you are a guest to this house, please wave your hand and let me see. If you are a guest, oh, come on, oh, come on. Let's do it better. Let's celebrate them. If you are close to them, please get up from your seat. We know how to do it, and let's welcome them. Let's welcome them.
We are one. We are one. For we are.
you so much. It's an honor to receive you, for you to be our guest this Sunday. Thank you so much. My singular honor to say God richly bless you for coming. We hope to see you again and again and again, and even to worship with us. God bless you so much. Amen. God willing, on Wednesday we are here 6:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. Hallelujah. It's indeed an opportunity to study the Word of God. And we meet here every Sunday from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. for our mentorship program. And then 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. as we have done for our seeker service. I believe that our pastor, esteemed pastor, Pastor Paul Edumensa, will communicate to your various platform our route for outreach this coming Saturday. Hallelujah. The church is looking for church workers in the area of the protocol department. We are looking for individuals that are committed and dedicated to this work. Hallelujah. And under the protocol department, we have ushers, we have greeters, and we have pass. And all interested persons, you kindly see Lady Pastor Lily Alamensa, Lady Naomi. Naomi, we don't know you. Wave your hand. Let's see you. Okay, good. Amen. And then also see Lady Gladys. Hallelujah. Amen. 40 years anniversary. 40 years anniversary. 40 years anniversary. I'm giving an announcement. I want to expand a bit. It's not easy to be 40 years old. It's not easy. People start church 2 years and it's gone. Hallelujah. 40 years. And out of the 40 years, some of us, we are part of the loins of the 40 years. Hallelujah. Amen. And indeed, the Lord is good. I want you to respectfully, okay? I want you to respectfully be upstanding. And let's clap our hands for Jesus for 40 years of ministry. 40 years. Hallelujah. Amen. That's how you clap for your entertainment people, but not for Jesus Christ. Amen. Respectfully, you can have your seat. Hallelujah. Because of that, we have beautiful, beautiful polo shirt. Amen. Beautiful polo shirt. It's fresh from the box. Hallelujah. It's not false, please. It's fresh from the box. Amen. And I'm telling you that it's very, very beautiful. And it's selling for 60 Ghana cedi. 60 Ghana cedi. Pair one. Hallelujah. It's not three, it's one for 60 cedis. And please see your community pastor and give your preferred color and size to him for purchase. We shall wear it on the anniversary day to celebrate God's goodness. Everybody will wear it. I'll wear mine, you wear yours. Hallelujah. With our nice jeans and, you know, and all that. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. We had our candle night back at Takoradi. And media, can you show us? I mean, it was beautiful. This was at one of our branches at Apramado. Amen. Please, I want to correct this. The 40 years is not city of his presence. It's the entire fraternity of God is our light. Amen. Media, if you have it, you can put it there. Hallelujah. It was beautiful. At that. Look at it. It's so beautiful. The women are wearing their T-shirt and... It's not because it's not here, that's why you are not clapping your hands well. Okay. This is a branch in Takoradi. Hallelujah. Again, I think I have a last. Good. Look at the kids there. Very beautiful. Amen. And our father and our mother is also there. Hallelujah. So please get your T-shirt. This is to whet your appetite. Amen. Please get your T-shirt. Amen. Hallelujah. We have nominated some people to go to the 40 years anniversary luncheon Atakurade. Hallelujah. And those individuals, you kindly see me after community meetings. Amen. Please, if you have not been nominated, please don't go. We need you here. Amen. If you have been nominated, please, you can go. Amen. There will be community meetings after service. Please be upstanding on your feet. Amen. Please, these persons, you see me after community meeting. Our brother, Nana Yao, and then our Lady Naomi. Hallelujah. Amen. Look at somebody and tell the person, if you don't stand with God when you are in trouble, he won't stand with you. Oh, tell the person again, if you don't stand with God when you are in trouble, he won't stand with you. Hallelujah. Amen. There are some people that are looking for things in this world. They have never found it. Amen. They have moved from several places. Now even charlatans who are called men of God, but they are fetished in men of God clothing. Hallelujah. Today I heard on the radio, they said, take orange and go and stand at the river and call some spirit to come. And this is a man of God. Hallelujah. And you have some people who follow them. And it will shock you. Some of them will be in this house. Am I communicating here? Hallelujah. Amen. Who told you devils don't know your family names and your parent names and all that? Hallelujah. When they go, they mention one name. This is it. Please, I want to encourage you. You need to be careful. We need sound word. We need the giftings as well. Amen. That is why I could have not preached and we could have prophesied and closed. But we need the word of God. It will help us. So this is just to advise you. Please be careful where you are going. Amen. And the kind of umbrellas or canopies you are entering. Am I communicating? Now hold somebody's hand gently. Tell the person, I love you. And I want to share the grace with you. Now let's share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. He has anointed our head with oil, our cup running over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Before we greet one another and love one another and go into our communities, there's one person here I cannot close without mentioning his name. It's very dear to me. His name is Alfred. Hallelujah. Amen. Alfred, we don't know you. Wave your hand and let's see you. Hallelujah. He's part of the media team from a distance and also closer. Hallelujah. And he's been helping us. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And Eric, his boss is Eric. You believe that? His boss is Eric. Or is Eric's boss or he's your boss? All right. Please, let's celebrate Eric. Today, he has confessed. Amen. Alfred, thank you so much. As a church, we appreciate you and every work you are doing for us. And God bless you so much. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, may the Lord bless you. May he keep you and may he prosper you. We pray that may he take us out of any plan of the enemy and any works of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask that he will envelop you in his presence. I ask that this week, may he bless you beyond measure. I stand in the grace of my calling and I pray for you that whatever is in store in the bosom of God's blessing for you this week, may it be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Every coven, evil coven, looking for your disfavoring, looking for your perishing, looking for your death, may it collapse in the name of Jesus Christ. May it collapse in the name of Jesus Christ. Every coven looking to distract your flow of life and your finances and your breakthrough, we cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. We cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. For I will sense in the spirit that anybody who is here, that your something is locked up, you are expecting this week, may it be open for you in the name of Jesus Christ. May it be open for you in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you May he keep you and may he prosper you. In the mighty name. May I pray, I don't know, somebody, your left leg. I pray for you right now in the name of Jesus that may the healing power of God touch you. May the healing power of God touch you. May the healing power of God touch you. It starts from your knee area. May the healing power of God touch you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. I love somebody, tell the person you will not die, but you live to declare the works of the Lord. God bless you and have a wonderful morning. Please, all those that are in class 101, please.